hackathon. My name is Jung-Jae Kim, and also known as JJ. So if Jung-Jae is difficult, you can call me JJ. My talk is quite different from any other presentation today, but my background is tax money, and I recognize the relations between entities in bio domain. But from few years ago, I now more focus on the ontology engineering. So one one of the interests I have now is when we have a domain where there is no ontology, how can we build an ontology? We can start with a small ontology created by domain experts, then how can we extend it? So ontology construction from scratch or ontology extension is the key topic here. And when I think of the sources, where can we find ontological information? Of course, if we dig into the expert's brain, we will get the domain knowledge, but for automatic method, it's not easy. So one source can be if there are existing ontologies, well-established ontologies in related domains. Maybe we can collect such information from those ontologies. If there are taxonomies, not necessarily ontologies, but still we can collect some relevant information possibly. Also, if there are, so today we talk, many of the presenters are talking about databases. From those databases, we can collect labels or text entries. Or we can use the text. We have literature, whole literature, and full text, we have many publicly available full text. From there, can we extract some ontological information? Also, among the text, we have many ontological annotations using Go and the Genia. There are many ontology and annotated corpora. So there are already quite many available sources. The question is how can we utilize them? So here I will introduce very briefly three systems my group developed so far. The first one is about equivalence relationship identification. Okay, in biodomain there are so many ontologies, and one of the key issues, the previous presenter talked about the mappings between the ontologies, right? So this task, ontology alignment or ontology matching or mapping, is to automatically identify semantic relations between concepts, especially the equivalence relations. If we extend it, it can be subsumption relations as well. Why do we need it? Because we want knowledge sharing. So something, information from one ontology to another ontology. So one key idea of the system I'm introducing is when we have two different relations between, let's say, the left lung and left lung alveolus, we know that these two concepts are not identical. But when we have this second pair, hamstring and hamstring muscle, we know these are identical. So just outwardly, only one word is added. One word, alveolus, make it not equivalent. The muscle does not change, right? So we found that there is some informativeness for words in ontological concepts. How do we know which is informative to differentiate to given labels? So for example, this is from one ontology, from another ontology, third ontology and the other ontology. So when there is an equivalence relationship between the heart handle cardium and endocardium, we can find that actually in this ontology, the parent of endocardium is heart part. So this word heart is already found in the context of endocardium in the second ontology. And ependema. So this one has a definition. If we according to the definition, there is a word brain. So we can understand that this word is related to brain, even though we do not have the brain word in the tongue. So by looking at the context of ontological concepts, we can find which are more informative, which are not informative, to differentiate two ontological labels. The second idea of this system is when the ontology one, let's say we are comparing two ontologies, ontology one has n one number of ontology concepts, ontology two has n two number of concepts. If we compare all of them, the thing is ontology alignment, the methods, they usually use very heavy analysis. So if we compare all of them, then it will be very heavy work. But if we narrow down the set of pairs which are likely to have equivalence relations, we can cut down the execution time significantly. So that's the idea. We use the vector space model. Okay. We use the OAEI, the 2010 data set for this purpose, and the human and mouse anatomy ontologies. As you can see here, our system is called BOAT, and the if-f measure is one of the best. The second figure, it shows that BOAT, actually this, if you compare this to one, same system, but this one does not use the candidate selection the method. This uses the candidate selection method. As you can see here, it does not affect f measure almost the time, does not affect at all. But compared to other the ontology matching system, this is the one of the best. And Loom is the used for the bio pattern, and our system shows the one of the best performance, also the best speed as well. So that was the first system. No, sorry, before I move on, the first part, the informative needs, it showed the increase of the F measure quite significantly, so it was quite useful as well. So after we developed a method to find equivalence relations between two ontologies, how about subsumption relations? So can we find subsumption relations? So of course, if we have equivalence relation, we can find subsumption relation. For example, let's say this is one ontology, and this is another ontology. Let's say we know this equivalence relation. If we have equivalence relation, we can, let's say this is subsumption relation, this is subsumption relation, or hyponym relation. Then we can understand this hyponym relation as well, right? Logically. The thing is, in many cases, not all the equivalence relations are known. Not all the ontologies have sufficient equivalence relations. Then can we find subsumption relations when we do not have equivalence relations? That was the motivation for this second system. Okay. Previous work, many people use Hurst patterns like the A such as B, A including B. But we apply these patterns in the bio domain. What we found is they show very low coverage in bio domain. So that was a problem. And then another methodology is to use instances. Let's say we have two concepts and we know their instances. If the instance set of one concept properly include the instance set of the other concept, then we can find subsumption relation. But problem is most of the biological ontologies, they are not instantiated. So what we do, okay, our background is the text mining. So what we used is, okay, we annotate text with ontology concepts and use ontological annotations on text as instances to use the instance-based approach. So key idea here is, if the two concepts have similar sets of instances, like this one, then maybe these are identical. If one set properly includes the other one, not necessarily properly, but mostly, maybe it means that there is a subsumption relation. That's the key idea here. So this work was done 2 years ago. At the time, two corpora, we thought quite well populated with actually, at that time, craft was not available. So what we use is the genial corpus and general corpus. General corpus is one of the corpus my group developed. So genial is based on the genial ontology, and general corpus is based on the gene regulation ontology. There is some overlap between the two corpora, but that's the relationship between genial ontology and GRO is not our interest. Our interest was the relationship between these two ontologies with BMS metadata source. Okay, metapixels, we don't have manual annotations, but we have the metamap. So we, for the two corpora, we used human annotations. For UMS metapixels, we used automatic annotator metamap. And then what we found is the best performance was around 70 to 80% of precision. One of interesting finding was we found some solution relations, and actually most of them, if you see the red color means most of them could not be inferred from the known equivalence relations between the two ontologies. So we found equivalence relations and used them to deduce these the substitution relations. But most of the substitution relations we found by using our system could not be inferred from equivalence relations. So it is very novel result. And we used it to automatically annotate text with ontology. The thing is, we have metamap for UMLS, but we do not have any automatic annotator for genome ontology. For event inspection systems can be used, but we do not have that sort of purpose. And also for GRO, we do not have. So idea is we use metamap to find UMLS concepts and convert them using these substitution relations to GRO concepts and genome concepts. What we found is the second system is called ZOD, and the first system was called BOAT, the equivalence relation identification system, and we used the Hurst patterns for this purpose, and the ZOD actually was quite good. And one more interesting thing was if we use the BOAT and Hurst pattern, the actual concept for a mention and the result of the automatic annotator, if the gap is small, means we find very specific concept corresponding step, the concept. But if the gap is big, means we find general concept, not necessarily specific concept. What we want is specific concept, but the general concept. If it's too general, it's no use. Right? So actually, the gap should be quite close, actual annotations and the automatic annotations. And so the result were very close to actual annotations. So that was the finding we had. So maybe it's a bit fast, but I'm moving to the last one. Okay, last one. After we find alignments between the two ontologies, how about can we construct an ontology from scratch? Okay, without any existing ontology, we just construct an ontology from scratch. This is not done in biodomain. We use other domains like the terrorism. So that's useful and so on. Previous work for ontology learning from scratch, they use statistical analysis, linguistic analysis, but statistical analysis, the problem is the precision was very low. Linguistic approach, precision is high, but problem is recovers very low. So one problem of using Hurst pattern is, whatever we do, it is restricted to sentences. We are not analyzing beyond sentences. There can be information for ontological ontology, which you can gather across the sentences. How can we gather information from across sentences? That was main idea, main motivation here. So one observation we found is, let's say we compare these two relations. When I say relation here, means subject verb object relation. So I find relation terrorist attack people, and I find relation terrorist attack American. What we can find here is American is a kind of people, right? So, so when two entities share same relation, so let's say in this case people and American share the same relation terrorist attack. Right? So if two concepts share the same relation, maybe there can be some relation, right? But there is some problem like the animal eat meat, animal eat grass. But the meat and grass, there's no relationship. So second observation is, if the relation set of one entity properly includes the other set, the relation set of the other entity, then there can be substantial relation. It's quite similar to what we have done before. This is formula, but I skip this part. So the main idea here, the method is called syntactic contextual subsumption, and this SCS. The other one is the using WordNet Hurst pattern. They are the previous works. So the main key difference is between this one, which used the previous method. This one is the using including the new model. And you can find that the number of concepts increase quite significantly, but the precision actually drops. But in terms of F measure, when we evaluate with the WordNet, actually the F measure, compared to previous works, it's quite much higher than the previous works. So that's what we found, and that's what. Okay, thank you.